Hey everybody, good afternoon. Excited to speak with you today. I don't know why, but God has this continuing message for me on the week of just forgetting about our past, forgetting who we were, forgetting about all of those things. Guys, when we walk in God, when we walk in Christ, when we make the decision to be different, it says we are a new creature in Christ, and old things have passed away, and everything is new. Our garments are renewed, like white, pure, white as snow, guys. That's what God wants to do with us, but we're trapped in our minds. We're trapped in our past. Today, God gave me a message for you, and it's basically this. Your flight has arrived, and there's no room for carry-ons, and there's no room for baggage. We're taking off. But we gotta leave all the plus ones behind. What's a plus one? Anything that happened yesterday. Anything. Anything that happened last week. Anything that happened last year. Anything that happened 10 years ago. Anything that happened to us when we were a child. We have to make an intentional decision that our flight is taking off and we're not taking any carry-ons. And we're not taking any baggage. We're going someplace new. God's doing a new thing in us. Think about it. When you're running a race and you're at the head of that race, you've seen the movies, right? The guy looks backwards over his shoulder. Boom. Trips. Falls. Stumbles. Loses the race. Guys, the devil wants us to look backwards so he can trip us up, so he can stumble us, so we can lose the race. But God wants us to look forward, right? And think about it. We're driving a car, right? Our car has a rearview mirror. Why? Because what's behind us matters, okay? We need to know what's behind us, but we got to keep our eyes focused on what's ahead of us. Because if we do more than glance at what's behind us, we're going to crash. If we spend all our time driving forward, looking in the rearview mirror, we're going to crash, guys, okay? There's some Bible verses that go along with this because I don't just like to give you a motivational speech, right? If it doesn't have the word in it, it's a motivational speech. I like to give you the word so you can know where this motivation comes from. In Job 17:9, it says, "The righteous keep moving forward, and those with clean hands become stronger and stronger." Guys, when we're walking in Jesus, we're becoming stronger and stronger. God is fighting our battles for us. He is directing our paths. This is the Bible. It's beautiful. We got to keep our eyes focused forward. And in Isaiah 43:18, it says, "Forget what happened in the past and do not dwell on events from long ago. Jesus is telling us this. What is in our past is not nearly as important as what is in our future. Matter of fact, our past is stepping stones for our future. Okay? We gotta climb the mountain. We gotta keep moving forward. We gotta keep pressing forward. The devil wants to keep us bound in our past and with our baggage. The devil wants to remind us that mistake we made yesterday. That thing that happened to us a week ago, how those people told us in our childhood that we weren't good enough and that we weren't worthy. But when you choose God, you choose newness. You choose newness. And when we look forward, this is what God says. In Psalms 32:8, God says, "I will instruct you and show you the way to go. With my eyes on you, I will give you counsel." If we just keep walking forward, and we just keep looking to God, He is going to instruct us. He is going to give us counsel. And we know, according to Romans 8:28, that all things work together for the good of those who love Him and who are called according to His purpose. You're called. You guys, we're called. I love God because He loved me first. He chose me. I couldn't even love God if He didn't give me a heart to love Him, but He did. So therefore, He wants good things for me. He doesn't want us with all this extra baggage. He said, "My child, your flight has arrived. It's taking off." But we can't get to where we're going if our plane is weighted down with carry-ons and excess baggage. So today I'm encouraging you to dump the excess baggage, to say, God, don't worry. You're going to pack my bags when I get there. You're going to supply my needs when I get there. You're going to have everything I need and want when I focus my eyes on you and the flight lands and I get to where I'm going, right? So I don't know who this message is for, but it's certainly a message that piggybacks off of yesterday's message. I'm not what happened to me. I'm who God called me to be. So let's stop looking backwards. The devil's in our past. Hurt is in our past. Shame is in our past. Rejection's in our past. Betrayal is in our past. Unworthiness is in our past. Abuse is in our past. Sexual trauma is in our past. Addiction is in our past. Stealing, manipulation, lying, murdering, whatever it is that you did, you are not too far from the grace of God. No matter where you are, you'll never be too far for God to reach you. All right, so the flight's leaving. Boarding passes are being handed out. You're standing in line. Get in line, get on the flight, but leave all your baggage, okay? I love you guys. I can't wait to talk to you again soon. Have a blessed day.